My name is Karen Chambers, and I am the Senior Director of Leadership Academy with New Leaders. And my role is simply to provide professional learning to all of our directors, centered around coaching and facilitation, and especially right now through the lens of equity. And what we do at New Leaders is that we do this work so that we're preparing educational leaders to make breakout gains in America's most highest need schools. So that's why we actually do this work. So my role is to get the directors and the facilitators ready to actually go out to get these breakthrough gains. And so I did that through a community of practice call, which was 2 hours per month. And I was so excited. I was like, yes, I get to go out and design and develop and think of all of these different things that we could do through the Zoom space. So we created sessions and PowerPoints, and we had time for people to talk and chat and on and on and on. And of course, you know, we got to Kirkpatrick's level one. Everyone was like, oh, that's so good. And so Henrietta and I started getting excited. She's on the call today. We was getting excited. We was like, oh, we doing our thing. And then after that, people started going to level two. And they were saying, oh, not only was it good, but we learned something. We learned something. It was like, oh, pat ourselves on the back. We doing it. And then when we got that book, Design for Modern Learning, we was just like, no, no, no. Y'all could keep those one and twos because we're not doing a thing, because we are not changing the on-the-job performance. And that's the most important thing. New Leaders, it said that we're going and have helped leaders do breakthrough results. And if people just saying they like something and learn something, we're not changing anything. So we had to think about, what do we need to do? And of course, Henrietta, she was so intrigued. I think that she read the book in one day, and I'm not joking. And she did some research and she said, guess what? They have a training. And immediately I went to my manager and I asked, can I participate? And of course she said, yes. And so I said, so let's think about, I can do work. I could design a learning cluster around our equity work, right? Because we know that our directors really need support in actually facilitating conversations on race. So I came up with my strategic objective, and I had all of these personas, Krista, if you could remember. And she was like, Karen, you're doing too much. She said, I need you to do one persona. When you think about this work, it is way too much. So I said, well, I'm going to focus on Doubtful Dan, because I know our directors, they know, they believe in equity. They believe in that work. They want to talk about race. They want to ensure that our students are receiving the instructional excellence and equity. They want to go out and coach and have every coaching conversation, a conversation on equity. They wanted to do it, but they doubtful in their abilities to actually hold the room, to actually engage in those conversations, to actually help participants to really reflect on their biases. So what we had to do was we'll go with Doubtful Dan. So then I say, okay, let's start thinking about, what do we already do, you know, so that we held close to our 2-hour professional development with our slideshow. What else do we actually do that we can build these learning assets around this persona? So we started thinking about, I'm going to do some one-on-one coaching. Because when you think about it, we have to really get, everyone knows that equity starts with self, right? So we have to really get them to reflect on their own biases, on their own identity markers, who they are and who they bring to this work. So we developed some one-on-one coaching sessions, which are going to begin next week. And we're going to talk about what gets you stuck, right? What gets you stuck when you get in front of a group and you hear these inequitable statements or you see these actions? What gets you stuck and not really engaging in the work? right? So that's one learning asset that we're going to do. Another one is, of course, I keep saying Henrietta because she was my partner, but she left me, went to another part in the organization. We discussed a podcast. So another learning asset we decided to do were podcasts, like have experts come on and really talk about their own equity journey. Talk about when they tried to hold the space. What happened? How did you recover? What's some ways that you are still working toward to develop mastery in actually facilitating and coaching with equity? And even though we know that those 2 hours by themselves are not productive, we included that in as a learning asset as well, because we know that our directors still need that learning support. But this time we differentiated them, right? So if you don't know how to handle trigger participants, you could go to that session. If you still need help with coaching for equity, guess what? You could go there. If you need to help with some probing questions on exactly how to get people to deeply reflect on their biases, you can go there. So we have different sessions designed for everybody's different persona as well. And then another thing that I think is crucial is that we have learning circles. So we said, let's have some learning circles where they can actually come in that space, actually share strategies, practice strategies, get feedback from one another so that they can continue to build community and grow and enhance their own knowledge about facilitation and coaching for equity. And I'm just gonna say one last thing, and that is making sure that they have immediate needs at their fingertip. So we are creating job aids. We created a best-in-class equity coaching guide, a best-in-class equity facilitation guide. We also have different protocols that you can use when you hear a trigger and when you hear something and individuals are triggered in the session. We have a protocol to help you to engage and to reflect, strategies to help them engage and reflect during the session. So that's some of the learning cluster. That's part of the learning cluster that I'm designing now.